Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta. Welcome back to RimWorld. We are going to pick up right where we left off at the end of yesterday's episode with the away team getting ready to roll out. Porkchop, what are you carrying? A cloth jacket? Normal? No, we don't put normal clothes over here. What are you talking about, you nerd? Oh, no. Normal clothes do not go here, Porkchop. What are you doing? I mean, I know I told you to do that, but... Bad girl. Bad girl. It's my fault, but bad girl. So yeah, when we last left off, we were getting the away team to head out and deal with the bandits. Now, a couple people said, are we going to put bedrolls out? I usually never put bedrolls out because I never, ever take that long to get there, nor do I ever stay where I'm going. And honestly, if I ever go out there I need to stay there overnight, what I'll do is I'll usually just build beds. I mean, it doesn't take that long to do so. Another thing to consider is that bedrolls, I believe that they do add to the carrying weight of the party, so I want to make sure that they have maximum amounts of space that they can carry, especially without having any caravan animals like, say, dromedaries or elephants and what have you. So also, I will say that the audio balance in yesterday's video was a little bit off. It seems like the game audio was a lot louder, so I apologize about that. Again, I'm still in the process of getting everything balanced. Thank you all very much for your assistance. Why are we traveling on one speed? Let's go. We got things to do here. All right, goal for today, getting the wall completely done, doing the bandit quest, getting the dead bodies out of here, and then also getting auto doors. So good job, coach. Go straight to auto doors. One thing already done. I'm going to temporarily add a door over here. This is just to speed up the clearing process. Force Strategy Gaming is currently sleeping. Baynard, if you could just do that for me real quick, I'd appreciate it. Where are other hauling animals at, man? We only have 3 hauling animals, that's it? We need to start getting some more hauling animals. Come to think about it, where are the other animals? I see Porkchop. I was curious. Roast beef. Where you at? She's hauling rice. Well, I mean, I guess they're all working. It just doesn't seem like it. There's a good tainted jacket there. Yeah, so this is tainted, but we can actually have that moved. Is there a reason why you guys are not taking the bodies out here? We need these colonists out of here, these corpses. Alright, so the night owls are going up and working on their stuff. While they're doing that, let's start to plot out where and how are we going to build our kill boxes here. Assuming that they're going to have to be forced to come through here, we can set up a kill box. I'm going to do this while the game is not paused so things can get done. So one thing I'm quickly noticing is that if we do a kill box here, we would have to deconstruct this. Because what we would do is we would have turrets lining on this side along with sandbags and walls. Same for this side over here. And they would be firing at this angle. Now, one thing that we could do instead of doing that is we could turn this into a funnel. We could say, hey, let me erase this real quick. Instead of them being able to come through this side, what we could do is we could say we're going to take... a 3-layer deep wall, which is, that's basically the tolerance for the AI not to try to cross. And then we can set up a kill box in here. So potentially what it will do is the invaders will come across through here. Again, assuming they do actually cross water, they would come through this side and we're going to funnel them all the way down to an open area. Because this is not a very large amount of space here. And actually, now that I think about it, it doesn't even have to be that thick there. Because what we could do is all we need to do is funnel them here. So we can close this part off. with this. So this part's going to be completely open. And then what we want to do is we want to force them into a confined space. So it can't be one by one. It has to be two by two. Otherwise the AI will not go for it. And we'll say like, hey, oh, look at all the bodies. Check it out. All right, they're gonna be coming up through here, and we want to basically give them a runaround. We want to make their lives not easy. So a lot of the times, whenever you see a YouTube video, you'll see these kill boxes set up to where you'll see them running through a maze. Now, one thing I will say about this particular design, and by the way, I'm just firing off the cuff here. This is not the final design for this kill box. But a lot of the times when you'll see a YouTube video from RimWorld, what they'll do is they'll actually have a series of mazes here, and they'll put like deadfall traps in there, or maybe they'll throw a Molotov and burn everything in there. And those are very effective. So that way, when they do finally reach the end of the hallway of the maze, they're already weakened, and then you basically dump them out. One, two. You basically dump them out somewhere like this. One, two. We want to make sure that they're funneling over here. So the invaders would come through this side, and then after they're done through all the traps, then they're finally going to be able to get out, only to be met with a flurry of turrets and stuff. And this needs to be basically open right here. So there would be a wall here, and probably a wall here. So it's just gonna be a shooting gallery in there. And actually, we'll probably open it up a little bit more. But this is the basic idea of what the kill box will be. So I'll leave that for now. It needs to be a little bit more windy. It definitely needs to come down more. Like it needs to be fed a lot more down here. Because we want them to be tired, and we want them to be weakened by the time that our guns finally get to reach them. Now, as with anything online, especially with games like this is always going to be a topic of, oh, this is not proper, you shouldn't be doing this, this is a stupid way, you do it, this derp derp. Yeah, that's great. But the thing is that this style of kill box is actually very effective. It's a style of kill box that I've used over and over again. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. Here we go. Daisy's caravan has arrived at the outpost. It's on. Fish, Matt, and McLean. What the heck is that? A Garlux? I've never even seen that before. Okay, so they do not have any turrets that I... Oh, no, they do have one turret. I'm more interested in, is there compact machinery? No, of course not. What kind of weird base are you guys living in? Okay. It's game time, team. Actually, if we can goad them to come out through here, this is a nice little corridor. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to have... He's got a knife. He's got an auto pistol. I didn't see, or the machine pistol. I don't know what the other guy had. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're just going to have a firing squad here, basically. So Daisy. Sinvicta can be right here. Because we don't want to get our people in a crossfire. Yeah, so I'll be like right here. Okay, then Jenna's going to have to be up close. So, who moves faster, Kate or Jenna? They're both good. Okay. So I think what I want is I want Kate to be the shotgunner here, and then Jenna will be the rabbit. And we're going to give him something to chase. Say, "Hey, you turkeys, come on over here. We got a special present for you." Okay, one down. Oof, I don't know what that was. Oh, that was someone threw a smoke bomb. We're going to back up and wait. Look out for McLean. Yeah, let's finish him off. No prisoners. No, no prisoners. Jenna, take him down. Kate. Nice shot, Jenna. We can't leave any witnesses. Nice. Oh, no, you guys are going to let him go. Oh, my God. Well done, team. Okay, so now we have to deal with the turret. So you guys come over here. Oh, that's cold-hearted, man. No, 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 no. Don't go that way. The turret will be able to see you two. Let's be sensible about this. Be smart about this. Daisy, you don't need to be cleaning dirt right now. That's a noble idea. It's a noble gesture. But they no longer have need for cleanliness. They've got a bunch of beds, though. Okay, so what we need to do, we need to safely take out the turret. And how you do that is, first off, we want to claim everything. So all this is now belonging to us. Okay. And then next thing we're going to do, we're going to sever the battery connection by simply uninstalling the battery. So I'm going to bring myself over here. Okay. Now I need to uninstall the battery. Daisy, don't do that. Okay, there we go. There we go. So that triggers the quest completion now. We can claim this turret. And now we can start breaking everything down. So we want to obviously claim the turret. And we're going to take that with us. The fire foam poppers, I don't know what they actually deconstruct to. But I'm just going to deconstruct it anyway. All right, so the turret's done. And we're going to say, hey, everybody, we want you to deconstruct all steel stuff. Because we're looking to get components. And sandbags do count as steel. They will also return steel, I believe. These auto doors? Nope. Nope, no auto door. All right, thank you, girls. All right, so right there we got some components. It's good. And once you're done with that, then we're going to just have them bring as much steel and components as possible back home. Okay, good. Good. So it's done. Quest completion. You defeated the enemy outpost. The payment from the Brio has arrived. The faction relations have also improved by 18. So we're almost in good. We're almost allies with the Kinley Gabrio, which is very good. We're going to go back to the world tab here, and we're going to say, hey, everybody, it's time to reform the caravan. Pick up all your stuff, grab everything that we can, and make out like a tree and split. All right, we're going to take as much steel as possible. 191 steel. Now, what I want to do is I want to take the battery, so I'm going to drop that down. That increased it by 40. We also need the turret. We don't care about the machine pistol. Where is the auto turret? Auto turret? Did they deconstruct it? You idiots! Why would you deconstruct the turret? We wanted it! Alright, well, there's that. Alright, so the battery. Take the simple meal, why not? All the components, all the steel, 140 kilograms. And, yeah. Ooh, hang on a sec. Well, there's steel beds, but we can't do anything, so. But an excellent steel bed might be good to sell. How much are these steel beds? Or they weigh 50 kilograms. Nah, screw that. Screw that. I'd rather have the raw steel. All right, so we're going to tell the away team, come back home. They'll be back in a day. It's going to take them a little bit longer to get here because obviously they're carrying a bunch of weight. So good job by the away team. Dodgers cooking. Then we'll finally have enough components. How long is the inspiration lasting for Maggie? 6 more hours. Yay. I'm glad we got used. I'm glad we used that time wisely. 4ce, what are you doing? Cooking? Why are you cooking, 4ce? I want you constructing. I forgot to put that's the reason why he's cooking, because I forgot to put his construction back at 1. Okay, so I'm gonna make another temporary door over here. This just allows our constructor and our hauling animals to get out easier. Save them time. Same thing probably down here. We're gonna have to build another door down here. And again, this is just in the interest of saving time for us to get around everywhere. Now, luckily, we have not had a power issue in quite a while, so I'm not really all that motivated to worry about the other geothermal vent right here. So let's think about our kill box, and if this is where we're going to go with this, let's see. Let me get some more stuff planned out here. Now, for the record, you don't need a kill box. It's not required, obviously. Yes, we finally get a bulk goods trader. Finally. Remove this. Okay, this actually needs to be one skinnier here. The bulk goods trader is going to be very, very useful because we need to get as many components as we can afford. Coach is done with the auto door, and I guess we'll start with the microelectronics. It's going to take a long time, but Coach Crendor is pretty smart. So, okay, we need our best socialite, which is going to be Dodger. Okay, let's see what they want. It would take our smoke leaf joints. It's good. We've got 3 herbal medicine, which is not even worth buying. We can get rid of all the poor quality clothes that we have made or have found. Excellent. Poor human leather T-shirt. I don't know where that came from. It's not ours. It's one of those daggum raiding tribes. Curse you. For using humans as meat. Okay, so now we need all your steel and all your components. They don't have either. Oh! Of course, I would get the tribal bulk goods dealer. I just now realized that. So tribal bulk goods dealers don't have metal. All right, well, let's just get all the money that we can off the table here. All right. I don't know where this human leather came from. It wasn't us, I promise. 937 is what we need to get to. Okay, so most of the money is coming from the Panthera fur. So we're just gonna try to get down to 37, perfect. Thank you for taking all that stuff. What is all this kibble doing here? Why is there so much kibble? Has all of our meat been going to kibble this entire time? Look how much freaking kibble we have. We don't need this much kibble. Get this kibble out of here. The heck? No. I need to expand the zone. There you go. You got a freaking mountain of kibble. Look at all that kibble. All right. Anyway, the away team should be back very soon. All these rotting corpses need to get hauled out of here. Is there a reason why they're not being hauled? What? Why are these not being able to be hauled over here? Do they constitute as normal quality? Wow, so putting them at normal quality makes... doesn't really make a whole lot of sense. I'm gonna be honest. I don't want normal clothes being brought over here, though. What's the priority on this? Normal, okay. Thank you, bulk goods dealers. I appreciate it, I suppose. It'd be nice to get a Mega Sloth. Mega Sloth would be very, very good at hauling stuff. I mean, we could try to tame it. Yeah. 10% chance to attack. We'll be fine. She'll be fine. We have skilled animal handlers. Not worried about it. The heel root is halfway grown, or quarter way grown. Hey, welcome back, everybody. About time. Sinvicta started a social fight with Jenna. What are you doing? Why would you ever fight if she's a beast? Jenna called Sinvicta a demon. This drove Sinvicta into a rage and began a fight. Dude, she's just telling you she's metal. She was just telling you you're metal. You got knocked out by Jenna. She bit my leg. Oh, no, that's Jenna. No, I bit Jenna's leg. What happened to me? What is this monstrosity of damage? She bit my left leg. She bit my torso. Cracked my femur with a fist. Headbutted me. Why would you ever try to fight Jenna in this game? She is unstoppable. You idiot. Someone help me. I've fallen and I can't get up. Maggie? Somebody? Anybody? A little help? No, I'm fine. Don't worry about me. I'm okay. I'm all right. Thanks, guys. And hey, technically, I didn't start the fight. Jenna started the fight. She called me a demon. Don't ever call me a demon. That's my word. Only I can say that. Don't worry, Kate. I'm just bleeding in the bed. I would actually die from Jenna biting my left leg and biting my torso. Where on my torso did she bite me? That causes death in 21 hours. Oh, thank you, Dodger. Thank you. Why is Coach Krendor doing that? Coach, you have terrible doctoring skills. Get out of here. This is the worst... Just get me out of this episode. This episode's... I don't know what's going on. People have lost their freaking mind. All right. Install this battery. Let's get things squared away here. Maggie, for whatever reason, is seeking solace. The soothing solace of a friendly battery inside of the barn. We need a proper battery, like, containment unit. I'm only gonna put this here just for now, but that's gonna rank high on the to-do list eventually, I promise. Okay, Daisy's botching the constructions. Good job, Daisy. Okay, does Jenna need help? Nope, she's treated. Okay, look. Hey, thanks for all the bandages, coach. Yeah, we have so much freaking cloth. Oh, thank you, Jenna. Thanks for tending to my wounds. How thoughtful of you. We should probably remove this horseshoe pin. Yeah, put it outside. We need an outdoors horseshoe pin. Ooh, all right. Hey, look, the wall's coming along pretty well. Still need you know what? We don't have any wood. Good God, man. Our priorities are just all over the place in this one. Jenna's still injured, but she refused. She doesn't need any medical treatment or anything now. The turret's sitting outside. Probably not going to help us at all right now. Okay. This is done. Let's get the granite wall up. We apparently need bridges for that, so let's go ahead and mark that down. It already exists because there's no wood. That's the reason why it's not being built. Thank you, Maggie. At least someone doing their job around here. Alright, all the kibble has been taken out of the preparation. That's good. Plain leather, we can have textiles in here, guys. All leathers can be stored in there. Well, not all leathers, but mostly most leathers can. I don't want to say all leathers because we don't want human leather in there. Not that we would ever have human leather for whatever reason. All right, temperature's looking good. Everything looking fine. Battery's already hooked up. Curious and Raphael sitting back, chilling. Husky felling trees. Thank you, Husky. Baynard cleaning blood off of the dirt. Thank you, Baynard. But things are going okay right now. They're just going kind of okay. We have 42 herbal medicine. With a whole lot more on the way. Why did you put our silver here? Which one of you jokers? Who did this? Who did this? Which one of you joking factions decided, oh, we're going to drop your payment. Here you go. Take this payment, nerd. Right on top of your roof. Unbelievable. We go out there. We do a quest. We kill people. And this is the thanks we get. Pure disrespect. This is a lot of money sitting here. Is anybody, nobody's gonna get it? Sleeping? No. Okay, well, you're already asleep. Baynard, what are you doing? Cleaning dirt? No. Deconstruct this. Haul that. I want you to haul all of this. Thank you, Curious. Our best. What? Kate started a social fight with Krendor. It's all going downhill. It's a complete revolt. Now what? Coach Krendor made fun of Kate's sexual experience. This drove Kate into a rage and she began to fight. Why would you do that, Krendor? He got his gun out! Death in 17 hours. Kate bit him on the left leg again, bit him on the right hand and the right leg. And Krendor destroyed her big toe. I don't know what's going on anymore. Everything has gone downhill all of a sudden. People are fighting left and right. We got money dropping from the sky that we can't get. Our wall still isn't done. We have the sorriest excuse for a battery containment unit I think I've ever seen in Rimworld. It's just all going downhill. Thank you, Ro. Thank you for doing something useful. Don't mind Baynard. Don't mind the shotgun either. Oh my god. Well, I think next week we definitely are going to have to sit down and look at our work priorities, getting the construction priority taken care of. Like, I'm going to do that right now because it's bugging me that no one is constructing. Sinvicta wasn't constructing because he was busy dying. Force is a night owl. Force is literally the only person actually doing any constructing. We can let Baynard go, but then he wouldn't be crafting anymore, which is fine. We need people doing stuff, so. Anyway. Good lord, man. It's just a... Thank you, Jenna. Thank you. At least Baynard and Ro are having fun. That's how we end it. So thank you for watching, everyone. Again, if you've been enjoying the RimWorld series, make sure you click the like button. If you haven't, click the dislike button. Either way, it helps out and supports the channel as well as the series. Make sure you're subscribing and clicking the notification bell so you get notified when my newest videos do go live. Like I said, I do appreciate all the support on the RimWorld series. We're going to keep on going. You keep watching, I'll keep recording. So hope you all have a great start to your weekend. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!